If you find yourself working in Canva and without the external mouse, you need not worry, because in this video we will see some quick controls to alter the length and breadth of any element, picture and shape. You can also resize text or any element that can be resized in Canva. Watch till the end, because I also listed out the details in a card and you can take a screenshot of it and save it for your records. Let's get started.
Alright, three things before we begin this video. First, whenever I say Alt key, that's because I'm using a Windows computer, and if you are using a Mac, it should be Option key for you. And these tricks may not work in the mobile version of Canva. Second, we're going to see four different ways of altering the length and the breadth of the elements, namely measuring, moving, rotating and resizing. And third thing, we are going to use these combinations of keys, Alt, Shift, Control, angle brackets and the arrow keys. So with the permutations and combinations of these keys, we are going to see how to measure, move, rotate and resize the elements. Measuring. When it comes to measuring, the Alt key is what we are going to use to show the measurement guidelines for any of the elements. And in here, you can also see the distance between two elements or the element's own distance itself within the canvas, the layout, the page layout here. So whenever you have an element selected, just hit the Alt key on your keyboard and it shows these measurement guidelines here from left, right, top and bottom. So you can see these are measured in pixels. Although it is counterintuitive, you just have to play around with the mouse pointer here, because wherever the mouse pointer is placed, then the measurement guidelines takes its relative distance on where the mouse pointer is placed. For example, now this pointer is placed here on the canvas itself, I mean the page itself. So whenever the element is selected and I'm going to hit the Alt key now, you can see that the measurement guidelines are showing in relative to the page itself. But what if we want to see the distance between two elements here? For example, this one and this one here. I'm going to place my mouse cursor on this element. No clicking, just place it on top of it. And while this element is selected, I'm just placing the mouse cursor on top of this and hitting the Alt key. You can see that the distance between these two elements are 714 pixels. If you want to see for with the text, just move the mouse around here. No need to click, just move the mouse around and move it over here to see its distance. And you can see and get the idea that to measure the distance between two elements, this is how we do. Keep pressing the Alt key and move your mouse pointer to show the distance between these two. I know it's counterintuitive to not to use, like this is all about keyboard shortcuts, but we still want to see for measurement purpose, use the mouse pointer on finding its relative distance between the elements and the page itself. So that's about measuring. Next, about moving elements. Now this one is pretty simple. We are just going to use the arrow key for moving an element 1 pixel. Moving this particular element 1 pixel, I'm using my keyboard arrow keys here. You can see that this element is moving 1 pixel at a time. If we want to move this 10 pixels at a time, then use the shift and the arrow key combinations. So this moves 10 pixels like this. So in both these situations, either you use the shift key or without the shift key, if you use the Alt key combination, this also shows the measurement guidelines from the sides or in relation to other elements present on your page. So I'm going to hit the Alt key and move it. And if you place the mouse cursor on top of this element and use the Alt key and move it, it will still show the distance between these two elements that we are covering in between while the moving the element as well. So let's say if you want to precisely place in between these two elements a gap of 200 pixels, then you can use this option by hitting the Alt key, Shift key and then moving the element. So now we have a precise 200 pixel gap in between these two elements. So that was about moving the elements with precise measurement guidelines. Now next, with the rotating of the elements with just using the keyboard combinations. How do we do that? For this, I'm going to use the Control and the Alt key and the angle brackets to rotate by 1 pixel. Control, Alt and the angle brackets. So you can see that these are rotating. I'm hitting the right angle bracket now to rotate it anti-clockwise and the left angle bracket to rotate it clockwise by 1 pixel. And if we want to rotate this by 10 pixels, then you can also hit the shift key along with Control Alt and the left angle bracket. And please note that in this case, it only rotates clockwise if you want to rotate by 10 pixels. So I'm going to hit the Control Alt Shift and only the left angle bracket works here, then not the right angle bracket. And this rotates clockwise. The right angle bracket doesn't work in this case, only the left angle bracket. So I'm hitting the Control Alt Shift and the left angle bracket to rotate this element by 10 pixels clockwise, one by one. I cannot even keep pressing this. I have to do it one by one. So that's about rotating 10 pixels clockwise. Next, I'm going to use the shift and the angular brackets to keep rotating both ways. This way. Now I'm hitting the left angle bracket and shift key combination. And this one is the shift key combination and the right angle bracket to rotate anti-clockwise. Again, we cannot keep pressing this continuously. We can only do it one at a time. So these were all about rotating the elements. Now, how about rotating the text element? Let's see that. I'm going to select the text element and I'm going to use the Control and Alt and angle brackets to do it one by one. So this rotates one pixel at a time clockwise. I'm hitting the left angle bracket, and with the right angle bracket, this rotates anti-clockwise one pixel at a time. Again, we cannot keep pressing this to rotate in one go in a faster pace, because if you keep pressing the combination, this will start adjusting the letter spacing. Let me show you that. I'm going to hit the Control Alt and the right angle bracket. Keep pressing it continuously, and that's going to adjust the letter spacing. Now I'm hitting the Control Alt and left angle bracket, and that adjusts the letter spacing. It reduces the letter spacing here. So we don't want to do that. And finally, if you want to rotate a text element by 10 pixels, again only clockwise, then you can use the Control Alt Shift and left angle bracket only to move it one at a time. 10 pixels at a time. So that's all about rotating. Finally, about resizing elements. So here, if you note that we have resizing options on the corners as well as the edges, but on some elements we only have it at the corners. So resizing only works whenever you have an element with the adjustment handles on the corner as well as the edges. It doesn't work on elements with only the corners. So let's pick this one for this demo, and I'm going to hit Control and the arrow keys to resize it by 1 pixel. Control and the arrow keys to resize it by 1 pixel, like this. Right now I'm hitting the right arrow and now the down arrow. If you see this rotating icon here, this means it is at the bottom. So let's keep the shape straight at 0 degrees. And now I'll display the demo here. So Control and right arrow resizes this element towards the right side, and down key resizes it at the down. Left one reduces it, and up arrow reduces it from the bottom. And this resizing is now getting done with 1 pixel at a time. If you want to do it in one go for 10 pixels, use the shift combination. So Control, shift and arrow keys to resize by 10 pixels. So as I told you, this only works if you have the edge as well as the corner handles, adjustment handles. But if you do not have that, then it wouldn't work. I'm hitting the Control and the arrow keys now, but there's no resizing happening here, neither with the shift key. So we just saw moving, rotating, resizing and measuring options using the keyboard shortcuts. And here's the list of all the keyboard shortcuts we just saw. You can take a screenshot now, or you can also download this as a cheat sheet. Just check the link in the description. Now here's a bonus tip. I know the motive of this video is to show only the keyboard shortcuts and mouse is banned, but this tip could easily fit into a hybrid model of using mouse and the keyboard shortcut, especially if you are someone who uses both the mouse and keyboard shortcuts. And this is for duplicating elements quickly. Here's what you do. Select an element and drag it while pressing the Alt key, and voila, you have it duplicated. Of course, if you are a keyboard purist, then Control D also duplicates the elements.
Thank you for watching. I hope you liked this video and learned something new. If so, please hit on the like button and click on the subscribe if not already done. And you can also watch my other videos that I made with the Canva free version that's available here in this playlist by clicking on this thumbnail. I'll see you again in another video. Until then, you please keep creating because your success is just around the corner. I mean it. Thank you. Bye. Take care.